Hello, and welcome back to the top 85 games for the BBC Micro Video Countdown series. In at number 44, it's a game called Spellbinder. Now, this is a truly original game for the Beeb, which was released in 1987 by Superior Software, and it was coded by teenage brothers Ethan and Dan Shirron, who were 14 and a half and 16 respectively when they first started putting the game together in 1986. So pretty impressive work for basically a bedroom developed game. Now this game is popular for all sorts of reasons, but one of them perhaps is the background music. Fans of the game are particularly keen on that music. It's actually based on a song by the Stranglers called Midnight Summer Dream, which came on their album Feline in 1983. So if you listen to that song carefully, you will in fact detect the notes of the Spellbinder background music itself. The game was originally named Mage Lords. You actually play the role of an aforementioned Mage Lord, but Superior's marketing team decided that it would sell better under the title Spellbinder. So, without further ado, let's take a look at Spellbinder. Okay, here we go. There we are. Superior Software presents Spellbinder. Yes, so a little bit of a story for you there. The land of Lorraine, 10 wise and powerful mage lords. So we play the part of a mage lord called Eldon, who's trying to defeat the evil Zorn. Great stuff. Okay, there's our controls there, and Ethan and Dan Sharon up in the credits. So it takes a few seconds to load up the splash screen. There it is. Amazing stuff. And then if you launch it, there goes the background. Great. Now, the controls, I have to say, it's nice that it lets you specify them, but I always get the backwards and the forwards one the wrong way round. So I'm hoping that I'll get it the right way for how I like to play the game. But we'll see whether or not I get it right. I'll soon find out. Anyway, it's all part of the fun, I suppose. Now, I mean, the first thing that you'll see when we get into the game is just how beautiful it is. I mean, look at the graphics on this. Isometric, just really, really good. Now you've got all sorts of controls at your disposal, so I can basically look at things with my eye. I can check my inventory there. And so I haven't got anything at the moment, obviously. If I have got things to mix together, then I can use them. But at the moment, obviously, I don't have any items or indeed a mixing tool. I can cast spells if I've got them, but don't have any at the moment. And that's pretty much the sort of limit of what I can do. Now the game is, as I say, set in a series of rooms. You can go ahead and explore. We go through here. We'll see if we can find a baddie. You can explore things like this chest here. There we go. Managed to find some burned ashes and toad legs. Excellent stuff. Not every chest that you come across has got anything in it, of course. There you go. That one doesn't have anything in it. So let's go and see what else we can find. Yes, I think there's a baddie down here. Whoa. Yes, let's not take him on just yet. But it's a pretty special game, really. I mean, I have to say, when I first played it as a child, I struggled a little bit with it because it is quite hard as a child to figure out what it is exactly you're supposed to do. Yeah, I mean, as sort of the graphics and everything else are concerned, it just looks great. There you go. Passages are invisible doors. There you go. So that gives you a hint that not everything that you see in terms of doors is all there is. There's more to it than that. This tells me helpfully that this is a table, which I probably could have worked out for myself, but good to know. So let's see whether or not we can get a little further into the game, shall we? Let's see if I can remember some of the little hidden details that you need to press on with. Actually, you know, oof, gosh, that was a bit scary. Do you know what? I'm going to try taking on this bad chap here. Well, not take him on, of course, because I don't have anything to kill him with yet, but now, yes, now if I remember correctly, if I look at that picture, woo, there you go, look, it's opened a door for us there. But before we go through there, let's go and have a quick explore around here. Nothing there by the looks of it. You do have to go up quite close to some of the items in order for him to really look at them. Poison the hungry one. Well, that sounds pretty morbid. Okay, let's see whether we can find something in this chest over here. Ooh, sulfur, eh? That could be useful. It's worth checking these suits of armor as well. You never know what you might find in there. Nope, nothing there. Okay. So now that we've had a look through here, Oh, hang on. I don't know whether we check this chest. Oh, a golden bar, a cork, and an air shield. My word. All sorts. Oh, there's a garden here. Don't know if we can. You have to, it's one of these games where you do have to sort of explore quite carefully, because if you don't, you run the risk of missing some of the hidden items. But it's been a while since I played Spellbinder, and I can't quite remember exactly which things are hidden and which things aren't. So it doesn't look like there's anything in this garden, but we'll make our way. I love the little sort of animation as he walks along, with his little wand there, sort of waving around. Alright, let's go through this secret door that we managed to open. Ooh, it's all purple now. It's quite mysterious. Yes, it uses colour in a sort of interesting way. It's kind of like Imogen, in the sense that it's monochrome, but obviously it uses different colours for the different rooms and levels. Definitely reminiscent of some of the Spectrum games of the era as well, I think it's fair to say. Only ever... Oh my goodness, what is that? Let's see if we can get into this chest before... Oh, there we go. Oh my lord, you know, you do have to be very wary of how much health impact you take, because if you take too much damage, your mage lord will obviously perish. Now, you know, you can... Unlike most Beeb games, Storm the Phantom, I'm not quite sure what that means. Yes, unlike most Beeb games, you don't have a health bar just on the screen. You have to check your potions bag. There you go, it says 63% at the moment. Ooh, gone yellow here. There's nothing in there. And you have to be wary of some of these ooh, I say, what is this? It's like a teleport. I wonder. Wow, that's very exciting. Okay, so we've managed to teleport into this room. Oh dear, I think this might have been a mistake. Oh dear, yes, this was definitely not the right thing to do. I don't have anything to fight him with, so I think this is going to be short-lived. Yeah, it's, my health is rapidly decreasing. I think one more hit and I'm a goner. You are dead. Alas, your quest failed. Well, there's a lesson to be learned there. Don't go for the teleport until you're ready. It's a bit of a shame though, because I've lost all of my components. So I'm gonna have to go and hunt around for those now. Okay, got my toad legs back. Always good to get those. Right, I think we went this way last time, so let's just get past that rather unpleasant thing. I do like those baddies though. Really well illustrated, aren't they? Okay, that's opened my secret door, but before we go through there, let's just retrace our steps and see if we can get hold of a few more items, because I'm fairly sure we managed to get some more things in this room. There we go, sulfur. I feel like that'll probably need to be mixed with something else. I don't think that'll do a lot on its own. Right, let's see what we got here. Golden bar, cork, and the air shield. Excellent. Oh yeah, this is the garden that had nothing in it, so let's not bother going through there. Yes. I mean, you know, it's as an adventure game. You know, I have my preferences for adventure games on the Beeb. You know, as we'll see in the rankings, there are other adventure games that I've brought in higher than Spellbinder. But graphically speaking, I mean, Spellbinder knocks the socks off a lot of adventure games that existed for the Beeb. There we go. We've given him a run for his money there. Okay, I've managed to find my telecharge. So let's get out of here before that thing devastates me any further. Right, now I think we go down this way. Oh, there we go. There's another chest there. Nothing in it though. So that's interesting. That's a one-way door. Look, that's put me back here again. So, let's see what we can do in this direction instead. No, that's just a table, isn't it? So that's not going to do very much for us. I don't think there was anything in that chest. No. Alright. Let's try, try a different direction. Do we have anything in there? Right, let's try going this way, shall we? Oh my goodness, I don't know what that thing is. Right, let's... Yes, not really doing very well there in terms of, oh yeah, what have you got to say for yourself? Use Alec's advice at the end of this corridor. Goodness. There's not very much in the end of this corridor. Anything from this picture? No, no secret doors in this case. Oh, good lord. I'm quite sure what that is. We can have a little nap here? And it helpfully tells me that I found some fleas in the bed. Well, not sure whether those are much use or not, but always best to just take things. I don't think there's any limit on how much you can pick up in this game. Fairly sure it's just inventory is limitless. What have we got here? A barrel. Lovely. Looks like there's another bed there. No, okay. Anything in this chest? Ooh, dried roots and burned ashes. How about this? No, nothing there. Ooh, some wine. Lovely. Okay. We've got all sorts of components, but I have to say there's not a lot that we seem to be able to do with them at this time. So, let's see. Oh, good lord, that eye thing is quite devastating. There we go. Let's go this way. Anything in here? No? Just make sure that wasn't me. Oh, hang on. Search the Iron Man. Now, that would suggest that we need to find something in a suit of armour, wouldn't it? But, I've pushed his axe. Doesn't seem to have done anything here, but if I remember correctly... Ah, we've got a heal spell. That's quite useful. How's our health looking? We're on 80%, so I wonder if I go to 5... There we go. Heal. So, let's... Wow, amazing stuff. So, that should... There you go. That's given me an extra 10%. Not too bad. Now, I think pushing his axe might mean... Oh, there's nothing... It's just a dead end, is it? Found some more wine, though. Let's never say no to a bit of wine. Oh, I think it's very unpleasant, isn't it? Right. Now, I think... Oh, goodness gracious. Who's this guy? Oh, dear. I didn't get a chance to explore that chest. Might not be anything in it, of course, but... would be helpful. I've got a mortar and pestle. That means that I can mix things together. Don't actually know what to mix with what, admittedly. Oh, I've got some worms, though. Would be helpful to get some sort of spell book, wouldn't it, to tell me what goes with what. Can't remember if that was something that you had to have from the instructions with Spellbinder, but anyway. Ooh, right, let's see if we can... Ooh, I don't know if we can get... There we go. Let's try looking in here. Some more burned ashes. Oh my goodness me. Right, I'm going to go along here, I think. Oh dear. My health is taking quite a hitting here. Right, let's go through. Oh, not that thing as well. Whoa. I don't know how much longer I'm going to be able to take this. Alright. Uh-oh, now I think... Doesn't that... Huh. I thought that by... touching the axe in the other room, that would actually change the direction of where I came out. Doesn't seem to have worked there, does it? Well, let's see whether or not we can go back through. No, see, it's... Oh, no, it has changed, hasn't it? Because that's not what used to happen when we came through here, so it's definitely changed something. Maybe I'm mistaking that. Perhaps it has. I just don't remember. No. This hallway was the same as before. So let's see then. Can we mix things together? Mix burned ashes. That doesn't seem to do very much, does it? It just mixes the burned ashes with nothing, by the looks of it. Yeah, not sure about that. Wonder what else we can try. Say the problem with doing reviews of these adventure games is that it can be difficult sometimes to do justice to them, just because they do take a fair amount of uncovering to make sense of what it is you have to do. And to be honest, Spellbinder isn't one of those games that I've ever completed myself, so it's a tricky one to do a sort of a decent review of. Well, let's go through here, shall we? I'm sure that there will be people watching, screaming at their computer screens at this point, saying, "No, don't go that way!" That's always the way with the adventure games, isn't it? Ah, well, we've got found a different garden this time. What's this? Oak leaves. Interesting. I wonder if we can find any kind of secret hidden passages here. No. I do have a vague memory of there being a some sort of secret passage through the garden, but no, I don't seem to be finding it this time. Let's just keep give a no, not nothing there. What about here? No. No. What about this plant? Just a plant, apparently. No. Okay. I think we're running out of options here. No. Well, I don't know. Doesn't look like we're getting very far here, does it? Well, maybe I should just go back to the... how are we doing on the health front? Ooh, only 43%. Oh dear. Not too good, is it? Alright, what about through here? Oh my goodness, it's the eyeball. Let's try this chap. Nope, nothing there. Yes, this is kind of the... I feel like the adventure game, if anything, is more suited to the adult player than the child player. I think children's, or at least my perseverance, was not... No, this is a different room. My perseverance with these sorts of games when I was younger was not great. Now, you see, find the passages between the trees, so there definitely is... some sort of secret passage that I'm not finding. More toad legs. Plenty of the toad legs and burned ashes. Oh gosh. So the real. Sorry about that. That was a bit confusing for those watching. Yes, these sorts of games are the sort that you can lose yourself in for many hours, aren't they? It's... ooh. Through the trees... I don't know. Not finding it, I have to say. Well, we'll try around the other side, but I think we might have to call an early close on Spellbinder as far as the actual walkthrough itself is concerned, because unless it's the actual... am I supposed to search the tree, do you think? Rather than the gap between it? Well, it does say through the trees, though. Yeah, the other thing as well is that with these sorts of games is that you really have to be precise about the bit that you look at as well, because if you... it could be that I've walked past the bit that I'm supposed to go through, but I don't know. Just endless series of nothing. I don't know. I'm not seeing it. Definitely not seeing it here. That's a little bit disappointing, but there it is. You can't win them all. I should probably have to give Spellbinder another go, another time. Perhaps look at a cheeky walkthrough online, maybe, and see if I can figure out what it is I'm supposed to do, or at least which of those tree passages it is that I'm supposed to... oh, don't... no! My eyes... no, no! Oh no! I didn't line up with the door properly! I didn't realise there was another one in this room as well. Oh no! No, that's just those cat things again. No! Ooh! We haven't been in here! Touching the altar, you hear moving stones. Oh, another one of these teleports, eh? Oh, well, it didn't teleport us into a room with an evil sorcerer. I think that might even have been Zorn himself we met last time, so at least we got to see him. Oh dear, watch how you go. Oh dear! Well, that was a bit of a shame. I seem to have walked through a door and fallen to my death. Well, I guess that's all there is to say on that matter. Well, I think we'll leave the final word on this video with the face in the wall there. You'll never get out. Looks like that's to be my fate as well. Doesn't look like I'm ever going to get out either. So I think we'll probably leave it there for Spellbinder. As I say, adventure games are a little trickier to demonstrate on these kinds of videos, but hopefully that's given you a flavour of the game. If it's one that you didn't play in your youth or previously, do dig it out. I always say that, but it is definitely worth it. Yeah, and what a great little game it is. Definitely rewards a deeper and longer play, I think, than I'm giving it here. But anyway, from Zorn, the evil Zorn, and from Eldon, I think we can say goodbye, and hope you'll join me for the next video in the series. Until then, goodbye.